there are smells around here that you've talked about, cedar, something that blows in from across the lake. And so this is a sensory place, and it certainly is a visual place. And what I'm getting a feeling of here is what I might call upness. In other words, these trees go up and up and up and right into the sky. And so there's a force here. It's a gentle force, but it's here. And it's where these red pines, keep going vertically, upness. So I look around the ground, I see red. I see red in the pine needles and the stuff that falls off the trees. I look with my viewfinder, and I close one eye, and I start to encapsulate certain chunks of these woods so that my mind doesn't go everywhere through distraction, and there's just too much. There's too much overwhelmingness here, and this helps me, settle everything down and take it in little bite-sized chunks, and that's why this viewfinder is so helpful. So I might just warm up with a doodle here, based on the simple forms that I see. Because I see red in the trees, I'm going to just dip my brush in here and exaggerate the colors like this. And there's a big fat tree here right in front of me. So I'm going to maybe make this a little brown. And so now you see what I'm doing. I'm trying to sketch in these monster and these primary verticals that I see here. Yeah, so this is kind of fun to do that. And you see this little paint kit, and one brush does it all. One brush will go like a mop, but it also will go like a point. If you dip it back in the water and hit it like this, it comes to a point. A good watercolor brush does. So you can see that this is nice and spontaneous, So I've got some greeny yellow things going on down there, and a little shadow in them. It's so much fun to do this. And you're really creating. And you don't care if the thing isn't exactly faithful to what's really here, because I'm here connecting with this stuff and having fun doing it and not putting any pressure on myself so that I have to be worried about whether it's exactly right or not. Right? And maybe if there's some green across the lake, take care of that. I'm being too fussy with that. So, think you can do that? Everybody can do this. It's a cinch. And now, how does that really look? Terrible. No, it's okay. So anyway, my little sketch has me making contact with the place, and now I understand what it's all about. It's got some blue and green and yellow and things, sticks on the ground. And then when I go like this, I'm framing, right? Is it pretty close? Yeah, I'm from side to side and top to bottom. So you can see that it's almost a painting. So that's what's fun about this. Using this kit, and it's handy, and it's like a handheld easel. So I've got something to paint against, and stuff on this knee and that knee, and all uncoordinated. The wind comes along and blows everything away. So I'm coordinated, and I've got everything that I need together to help me paint. So I can. It's even better. Thank you.
Thank you.